Assalamualaikum, how are you guys? I welcome all of you in today's video tutorial. In the last video yesterday we started new topic fraction and we studied about the basic concepts of fraction. Now I think you are able to define fraction. You know what is numerator, what is denominator. You can even write a fraction. You know the difference between unit fraction and non-unit fraction. So today we are going to start from comparing and ordering fraction, and you can find a picture on your screen, and this is the different fractions I represented here. Starting from 1, then it is going to be divided into 2 equal parts, 3 equal parts, and so on, and it is going up to 10. So you have to check here which is the bigger part, which is the smaller part in the fraction, and this picture will help you to identify the smaller parts and the bigger parts in a very easy way. So consider it that these all are the chocolate pieces. So start from the one, the first one is the chocolate bar. All are the chocolate bar. The first one, obviously, if you are going to if I give you one chocolate, so you are going to have it alone. But if I say that you have to divide this chocolate into 2 equal parts, and one you give to your friend and one you will eat. So now you are not going to have the full chocolate because it is divided into 2 equal parts, and you are going to give one chocolate bar to your friend and one you are going to have. So when you were eating the full chocolate, so you have a larger portion to eat, but now because you give half of the chocolate to your friend, that's why you are now going to have a half of it, and you have now smaller portion of the chocolate rather than the previous one. But when I say divide your chocolate into 3 equal parts and give one of to your friend, one of to your brother, and one of them, well, one of the piece you will eat. So now you are going to have a smaller portion, because when you give it to when you divide 2 equal parts, so you have one half of the part, but now it is 1/3 part you are going to have, and every 1/3 part, you 1/3 part you will eat, 1/3 part your friend will eat, and 1/3 part your brother will eat. If you are observing that the way you are going down and down and down and down and down, and you are dividing that dividing chocolate in so many number of equal pieces, so you are going to have a smaller portion to have. When you have one chocolate, you eat full. When you have, when you divide into 2 equal parts, you eat half. When you divide into 3 equal parts, you will eat 1/3. When you divide into 4 equal parts, you will eat 1/4. Same 1/5, 1/6, 1/7, and up to 1/10. I mentioned here. So what you are getting, that if you look here, 1/2 or 1/3. So which is the bigger portion? What do you think? Obviously, 1/2. Because 1/2 have a larger portion, larger area, which you are going to have. If you are having chocolate, so you are going to have half of it, and you will eat larger portion rather than 1/3. Because same chocolate is divided into 3 equal parts. If it is divided into, same chocolate is divided into 1/4 equal parts, so then you will see 1/3 is bigger than 1/4. So if you consider 1/4 and 1/5, so 1/4 is bigger than 1/5. The more equal number of pieces you will divide the chocolate, the less you will eat. Okay, so that is actually in fraction what you have to see. In fraction you have to see if you have the same numerator and the denominator is getting increased, so that means the fraction is it will be the less fraction. For the comparing fractions, so the same thing I mentioned in here, and zoom in, that 1/2 and 1/3. I told you that consider it as example of a chocolate bar. If it is a chocolate bar, 1/2 and 1/3, which piece of chocolate bar would you like to have? Which is the bigger one, 1/2 or 1/3? If you look at 1/2, so obviously 1/2 is bigger than 1/3. So you will say 1/2 is more than 1/3. And also you can say 1/3 is less than 1/2. Same, you will see that 1/3 is bigger than 1 over 4. If you want to have chocolate from 1 over 3 or 1 over 4, obviously you will go for 1 over 3. That's, that means 1/3. The one chocolate bar which is equally divided into three parts, not you will go for that chocolate which is divided into four equal parts. So 1 over 3 is greater than 1 over 4, or you can also say that 1 over 4 is smaller than 1 over 3. If you arrange all the unit fractions from greatest to the smallest, as we saw in the last figure, so we have first 1 over 2, the bigger one, then 1 over 3, then 1 over 4, then 1 over 5, then 1 over 6, 1 over 7, 1 over 8, 1 over 9, and 1 over 10. And you can say that when numerators are same, so the more the denominator, the less the fraction. Right? When the numerators are same, the more the denominator, the less the fraction. And that's mean if you are going to have a chocolate, the more it will be divided into number of equal parts, the less you will eat. Right? And the less number of pieces divided for one chocolate, the more portion you are going to have it. Now we have like fractions. In the previous slides, we studied about the fraction that were having different denominators, like 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 1 over 4, 1 over 4, 1 over 5. So what is like fraction? For like fractions that have the same denominator, the fractions which are having same denominator are called like fraction. You can see the picture here on the screen. If you consider it the same chocolate bar, so it is divided into, also it is divided into seven equal parts, but there is 1 over 7, 2 over 7, one part is shaded in the first one, two parts are shaded in the second one, and same 3, 4 and in the last 7. So that's meaning 2 over 7, you are not going to have only one part of the 7th equal parts. Now you are going to have two equal parts. So the more number of equal parts you are given, so the more you will eat. In like fractions, when you have same denominators and different numerators, so the more the numerator, the more fraction, the greater the fraction. If you look here, 1 over 2, 1 over 7, 2 over 7, 3 over 7. And if you observe the shaded colors, so the more you go down, so you will find the greater the fraction. The first one is having the one shaded, 1 over 7. This means only one part is going to be given to you for having chocolate. In the second one, two parts are going to be given from out of 7 parts. In the three parts out of 7. Are going to be given to you, and in fourth. And if you come up to six parts out of 7 parts are going to be given to you, and in the seventh, 7 out of 7, this means whole parts are going to be given. One more thing you have to notice here, when the numerator and denominator are same, that's mean 1, 7 total, as we discuss in the last class, what denominator is telling about? Denominator is telling you about total number of equal parts. So total number of equal parts are 7, and the numerator is going to tell you about the number of shaded. So all are shaded, this means there are total number of equal parts 7, and all are shaded, 7 over 7. So whenever you have same number in the numerator and same number in the denominator, so that means it is 1. Okay. So can you arrange them in an order from smallest to largest? It's very easy. If you look at the picture, so it is 1 over 7 first, then 2 over 7, 3 over 7, 4 over 7, 5 over 7, 6 over 7, and 7 over 7 when you arrange from smallest to largest. And if you don't have a picture, so don't you worry, because when you have same denominator, when the denominators are same or in like fraction, the more the numerator, the greater the fraction, because the more number of shaded pieces, so the more the fraction. Next slide is how to make one whole. So I told you that whenever the numerator and the denominators are same, that's mean 1. So if I give you different fractions and I ask you which two fractions can make 1, so can you tell me? Let's have one example. There is one example that is saying 1 over 4 and 3 over 4 makes 1. Do you agree with that? 1 over 4 is the one portion out of 4, and 3 over 4 are the three portions out of 4 portions. If we combine them, so 3 over 4 and 1 over 4. So 3 plus 1, 4 and 4 out of 4. So that will make 1, right? Next we have 2 over 9 and 7 over 9. If we have one fraction 2 over 9, so what we need to do, we need to add something in 2 to get 9, because we want numerator and denominator to be same in order to get 1. So 2 over 9, what we need? We need to add 7 in the 2 so that we can get 9 over 9, and that will make us, that will make 1 for us. Same for 3 over 5 and 2 over 5. If there's 3 over 5, then 3 needs 2 to become 5, and 5 over 5 will make 1. 2 over 6 and 4 over 6, so 2 plus 4, 6, and that will make 1 for one. If I ask you different examples, let's suppose 2 over 3, and what is the second number in order to make 1? So you will find then what number you should add in 2 in order to get 3, because 3 is the denominator. So you will say, yes, it's 3 over 3. If I ask you about 1 over 4, and can you tell me the next fraction in order to make 1? So obviously 1 over 4, you need to make it 4. What number you should add in 1 in order to get 4? So 1 plus 3 equals to 4. So you will say, yes, 1 over 4 and 3 over 4 will make 1. Now the next slide we have, circle the greater fraction. Circle the greater fraction. In A figure you have two circles, and in the first circle it is divided into 6 equal parts, and in the second circle it is divided into 8 equal parts. So can you tell me the greater fraction? Yes, you can easily tell by looking at the picture that 1 over 6 is bigger than 1 over 8, and you can also tell by remembering the verse or explanation which we did in the last slides, that when you have same numerator, so the more the denominator, the less the fraction. As you see in the 6, the denominators are 6 and 8 in the figure, so the 8 is bigger. This means it is the less fraction, because numerators are same here. If you look at the B figure, so 1 over 4 or 1 over 9, obviously the numerators are same also here, 1, 1, and the denominator 4 and 9. So the more the denominator, when you have same numerator, the less the fraction. So what is the bigger number here, 4 and 9? Obviously 9. So 1 over 4 is going to be greater fraction here. The next we have, circle the smaller fraction. Here we don't have same numerator, but we have same denominator here. If you look at the figure A, it is divided into 7 equal parts and 2 parts are shaded, and another figure in A is divided into 7 equal pieces, but 5 are shaded. So 2 over 7 or 5 over 7. If you remember, when you have same denominator, the more the numerator, the greater the fraction. So 2 over 7 and 5 over 7, obviously 5 over 7 is greater than 2 over 7. So you have to circle the smaller one. So 2 over 7 is the smaller one. If you look at this pentagon, 3 over 5 and 4 over 5. So yeah, obviously there is also same denominator, 5 and 5, 3 and 4. Which is bigger? 4 is bigger. So 4 over 5 is the bigger fraction. You have to circle the smaller one. So 3 over 5 is the answer here. So this is going to the end of our today's video tutorial, and I hope you have got all the concepts regarding a smaller fraction, greater fraction, and you can do some exercise. I will also share some of the questions with you to make you practice, and you can also search from the internet and practice, and I'll meet you in the next video with equivalent fractions or some more concepts about fraction. Till then, have a nice day, and thank you so much for watching. Take care, have a nice day.